Good morning, class 5. How are you doing? I hope you all guys are doing great and fine. So, studying also, eating, sleeping, having fun, playing. So, everything in the same proportion. It's great to see you back again. Means you can see me, I can't see you. Anyways, so we'll be there on English again on that course book, Love Across the Salt Desert. We were talking about Run of Kutch. In Gujarat, how the salt happens, what happens there, and it is about rather we can say it's about a love story of this person who goes to Pakistan and bring back his to-be wife to this part of India, this side of the border to India, where he lives. And the rain starts falling, and people say that you are very blessed that you have come, you have brought us the rains. I had told you the story about it. So today, what we are going to do, this was an extract from Love Across the Salt Desert. I had given you the whole story about it. So we'll just go through it again. I'm going to just read it today, and after that, you will attempt the question answers and everything you will do, okay? And rest, I'm there always. You first attempt it yourself, and after that we'll go ahead with it, okay? So, Love Across the Salt Desert is the extract taken from Love Across the Salt Desert by K.N. Daruvala. The run of Kutch is vast, lonely desert, almost impossible to cross, yet some people do cross for its reasons of their own. Najab Hussain also crossed the vast desert for a very special reason. Najab is also a Muslim, but see, he's staying in India, right? He's staying in India, and at the same time, he's going to go to Pakistan, but people don't like him there because he's an Indian. So he may be a Muslim, but he cannot just go ahead and cross the border just because he's a Muslim. The drought, no rain in Kutch has lasted for 3 successive years. There is no rain in that place for 3 years. Even when clouds were sighted, they passed by, ignoring the stricken country. The monsoons had, so to speak, forgotten to land. The run lay like a paralyzed monster, its back covered with scab and scar tissues and dried blistered skin. The earth had cracked, and it looked like as if chunks of it had been baked in a kiln. The earth had cracked and looked as if chunks of it had been baked in a kiln and then embedded in the soil crust. The cattle became thin and emaciated. The oxen died. The camel alone survived comfortably, feeding on the bawal camel thorn. Then one day the clouds rolled in like wineskins, and the lightning crackled and the wineskins burst. Though 2 years have passed since the drought ended, everyone remembers that it first rained on the day when Fatima entered the village. This is how she came. So at the starting of this only, they are giving you the information that what actually happened, right? So this part is only saying about the condition of that area. 3 years there was no rain, and that run of Kutch was just lying like a paralyzed monster. What happens when a person lies, becomes sick, or he doesn't drink water and he's paralyzed? You know, you cannot move. What will happen to your skin? It will get cracked, you will have sores, you will become dry, you will not be having a bath. So it's like that. The whole land had got dried up, like skin comes up, isn't it? When something dries up, you'll see the skin starts erupting. Even in vegetables, you see how they become crunched inside when they don't have that moisture or they don't get that water. Even plants happen like that. Even you will happen in winter if you don't oil yourself, if you don't take care of yourself, if you don't eat fats, if you don't eat oil, if you don't eat protein or carbohydrates, what happens? Your skin will also start cracking. isn't it? So like that, the land is like that. See, when many places also in the field, you will see in your farming field, when there is no water, the water is not given to that land, what happens? The mud cracks and becomes into pieces, chunks, as if someone has gone and put it there in the kiln. What happens in the kiln where you make bricks? It's put in, it's baked inside the fire. So when they are baked, they come out solid and they put there. Those who don't bake, they get cracked. So that's what he's saying. When you don't get any water, the land gets different, you know. And the clouds come and they forget to rain, they go away. But suddenly, animals were also dying without water. You know, the oxen died, but the camel is the ship of the desert. So he doesn't need water, or she doesn't need water. They store water and fats inside their body. They eat thorn plants as cactus and all. And bawal. Bawal here is some food or some plant. Bawal is a plant. And camel thorn. Camel thorns are a kind of shrub in the dry areas. You have camel thorns like cactus plants and all. Then one day the clouds rolled in like wineskins. You know, wineskins are those animal skins which are dried up and tanned, and then they put wine inside it or water inside it, and they take it with them and they hang it on the camel backs or whatever they take it. So the clouds had come in like that, bringing water, full of water. And suddenly those wineskins, the lightning crackled and the wineskins burst and the rain started falling. Though 2 years have passed since the drought ended, heavy rain, massive rainfall was there. Everyone remembers that it first rained on the day when Fatima entered the village. Fatima had come from Pakistan. This is how she came. She brought in rain, she brought in happiness, she brought in gladness, she brought in everything. The dryness which was the sorrows, that is what the writer is trying to mean. What would he do not for her, the daughter of the spice seller, she who smelt of cloves and cinnamon, whose laughter had the timber of ankle bells, whose eyebrows were black like wisps, of the night, and whose hair was the night itself, for he would cross the desert. For her, he would cross the desert. They're showing, they're saying, what beautiful that this girl is, so beautiful. You know, the spice seller's daughter. He was a smuggler. He used to, he used to bring in spices from Pakistan. And she was smelling of cinnamon and cloves. That's darchini and long. Such a nice smell was always coming out from her, whose laughter had a timbre, means the music. Her laughter had a music of ankle bells. Like when you walk, chan, 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 that makes the pile sounds. Like that, when she was talking, there was music in her talking. She was so nice, soft-spoken, very nice, whose eyebrows were like black wisps. Eyebrows. Just thin lines of black wisp, just like a hair, so beautiful she was. Of the night, like a thin line in the night, you see. And whose hair was already night, that means her hair was very black. For her, he would cross the salt desert. For this beautiful lady, or this beautiful woman, this beautiful girl, this boy, Najab would seriously cross the desert and go and bring her. He had stayed the day at Kala Dongar, a black hill capped with basalt. It's a basalt is a rock type of thing, a salt rock. It's a salt rock. It's kind of a black stone. You see basalt. You'll see quite a lot of places. You'll see when the trucks come in or the dumpers come in to make roads, they bring in big stones and they have holes in it. They carved in green color type, green brownish color. They're not mud. So they are called basalt. When there were volcanic eruptions, these things come out, they get cooled and they become basalt. The highest in Kutch, that was the highest hill, the Kala Dongar. He had set his camel Allarakha free to crop on the bawal trees. There were some plants, you know, trees with leaves. As I said, bawals is another plant or something, a tree with leaves that he, and the camels are tall, so they can eat. So he had left Allarakha. Allarakha was the camel's name, and he was eating away. So I'll come back in the next video.